local name is Muvango. This is the one that the roofing poles in the house.
Yeah.
This is the timber that they use. Okay. This. It's very hard to find long straight pieces. Mm. So that, if you ask them to make roofing poles on your house from Muvango, mm. it takes the guys a long time to get the poles.
Go on.
I've never seen so many sausage trees in one place.
Well, you can see the sausages on this lucky bean. These are the ones in dry season that these seeds go really hard mm. and they get like a black eye on them. Mm. Crab's eye. Local women use the roots of this to make tea to get honey.
Mm. Well, should we take a couple back with us?
Yeah. But if you eat the seeds, there's I can't remember what the poison is within it, but if you actually crunch through the shell of the seed, mm. they're not good for you at all. On the elephants, which are living on the land. Mm. I said, well, is the rod not impact?
Is that one of the 150
land cruisers in amongst them is surely a bit more impact than my boat 100 yards away from them in the water. I said, is there an actual rule? No, there's not actual rules. I said, so you're telling me that it's legal for me to do it, but you're telling me I'm not allowed to. Then why not make it a law? Mm. No, we can't. Parks are open access. So we'll stop being
a twat.
Fucking stupid, you know?
Did you get that, Dave?
It's all on here.
If you want to if you want to throttle...
This is just Dan explaining the park's rules and regulations.
Activities, then start doing stupid things like that. If you want to increase tourism, have more money to protect the game, you know, a la Chobe National Park, which has the highest den concentrations probably in southern Africa, then leave it open, you know, and let people use it.
There's something over there in front of us, directly in front of us.
Yep.
Liquid.
Baboons.
Oh, baboons.
One in the tree as well. Sitting in the tree there.
Mm-hmm. Here's a kudu. Here's a kudu. Here's a kudu.
Oh, look at that.
Prints are in the tree. They're having a fight. Who are they having a fight? You got some.
Yeah, somebody's got some food there.
Yeah.
Very likely with those things, aren't they?
Yeah.
What's the full name? Horseshoe Bend? Or just Horseshoe?
Local name, Uhuru. Much nicer.
What's through the trees there, that kind of thing?
That's Horseshoe. It's an exact shape of a horse's shoe.
Who's down?
We're on the bottom left of it now. It goes around to a semicircle on the right, 180 degrees, and comes back on this side.
You're looking straight through the trees at the sky on the other side.
It's like the icon of the cathedral.
This is beautiful.
Yeah.
And it's where the elephants come to. I know somebody that's seen 900 elephants at Horseshoe. I'd say probably the most I've seen.
What are they called, those spider webs there? I can't remember.
It's community spiders. I don't think so. That's
one place on our back, I can't remember where. They were one after the other, the bushes at the side of the road.
They catch both?
No, the spider webs.
Oh, well, they're covering the whole branch.
Yeah, like that there behind you.
I think they catch both, Chris.
And you can get elephants here at midday. You can see about a third of it now.
I thought it was just that bit then.
Oh, I've got to get a picture of this. I've got to try and get a picture of it.
Oh, this is my favourite camera, so give me a panorama now.
Just put yourself on fisheye lens.
No, I've got a panorama thing.
Oh, where you can...
You take three pictures at a time.
Let me just move forward a bit now, so you can see more of the pictures. First lion I ever saw in my black tie, so I
a big panorama, this one.
Yes, did you fuck that one up, Chris?
No, watch. It stitches the whole thing together.
I don't believe it.
Yeah, it does. Mm-hmm.
Right. Don't stand up there, Dan. Pumps both of them. Yeah, hold on to that.
Yeah, I got it. Strong. I got it.
Ross.
They're not usually here, they're usually up there. They're fine for the pots. Or it's the Saturday night.
Look at the baby here, right at the front. We came up this way, didn't we?
There's more in the tree here.
Yeah.
Senegal. Right.
Tuesday morning. This is the campsite that we've been staying in since Saturday. Saturday we stayed here. Sunday we went out and we stayed on the island. Last night we stayed here again. And now today we're off again. This is Dan's place. This is his main campsite. Kitchen, fire area, looking over the river. Chris and Nick, they camped here, and we were just behind over there. Dan's in the process of building up a new campsite, which he's hoping to have completed. Oh, here's the toilet. What about that? There you are. There's the throne. So you dig a hole with a spade, put the frame over the top of it, cover up, and you're finished. But he's in the process of building these new units, which will have all your own facilities. That's where Dan lives. That's his tent. Because here will be like a fireplace when this is all complete. Stages will be by September. Each unit will have a fireplace. This will be their kitchen area. We'll wash up. And this will be the bedrooms there. You're using this one as a storage facility at the moment, but that's what you're going to be looking onto. There you go. Each unit will have its own bathroom. It's over here. The boat popped down there. The bottles in the wall, when the sun's on it, it shines all these nice green and white lights. There you go. That's going to be your shower. Bathroom area. And that's what's going to be the toilet. Where we've been showering the last couple of days. It is the dressing area. Chubby game reserve now. Coming down a quite a severe track, and this is in the way. just been dumped, just been left behind.
Been a 4x4 in through the park. Listen to that engine purring away. Just flowing along here. The valleys have moved God down.
Now they're probably on their 8th Guinness.
Yeah.
It's going to be a very short wheelbase, isn't it?
We got an elephant in the middle of the road up ahead. We just had one charging at us, and this one doesn't seem to be moving. Ah, he spotted us. He moved off to the side. Going in.
I tell you, they just come straight out. So you gotta be a little bit cautious in on the ball.
He's gone. Yeah, he's gone.
Two more caves of this and we're there, don't
we? Just out the corner. Some good rods.
Second gear, clutch in.
Just ready. He's looking at us. Three bulls in front of us. Thank for moving off the road.
Oops.
see if we can get it off. He's in the process of pulling that whole tree out there, check it. Looking about 8 meters away from us now.
So it could be the problem.
So the one move there. No, he's gone. He went into the bush. Yeah, he's here. He's here. He's here. He's here.
He's here. All over here as well. We've kind of cut him off.
Oh, here. Oh, here he comes. No, he stopped. Here. Yes.
Coming.
Yep, he's here. We're going to try again to get through. Here he goes. Go. He stopped.
Okay, but on the right.
There's a whole lot of them there. Yeah, they're gone.
Welcome to Chobe, eh?
Yeah. Classic. That's more. Campsite tonight. We're going to be staying tonight. No fences, no protection. Lions, cheetah, leopard, elephant. It's been raining today, but elephant's been here this afternoon. There's his footprints. Did a bit of a walk around here and then walked on down. The proper rod is solid. Yeah, I doubt it. This might be a longer drive than what we thought. Are they coming through? Yeah. Are they through? Good afternoon, Dutch Storms. We're in Moreni. It's Moreni, yeah. Moreni. Okay.
Okay, you watch from the left here.